We're here with the man with a thousand voices, Roger Romo, Triple G, against Curtis Stevens.
That's a good fight with two dudes that can crack. Smart money's on Golovkin. To me, he's been improving every fight. He doesn't get to show it a lot because he stops everyone, but I think that in this fight, he's going to get tested, someone that actually hits back. But I think he should take to it, especially with all the investing they're doing in the kids. So I think that Golovkin pulls it out by knockout, probably late, probably about 8 or 9 rounds.
You're from Oxnard. Right. You were a boxing prodigy growing up. You're a pro fighter, undefeated. Break down Mikey Garcia, Rocky Martinez for the 130 world title. Going down on HBO November 9th from Corpus Christi.
I think, not just because I'm from Oxnard, not just because I know Mikey's family and they took care of my brother and us when we were kids. And
your brother, Fernando Vargas.
I think Mikey's... an awesome fighter, intelligent, not just inside the ring, outside the ring. You could tell by the way you speak to him and the way he speaks back. He's an intellectual in the sport, and I think Mikey is just, I don't think anyone out there in his weight class right now could beat him. I think it'll be a good fight, but Mikey's going to pull through, I think, probably also late stoppage. If he stops him early, though, I wouldn't be surprised, but I think Mikey stops him and he gets himself another world title.
They asked Freddie Roach, who are you scared of from Team Garcia? Is it Robert? Is it Alex? Is it Brandon? He said, no, the Big G. You know the Big G. He trained your brother. He trained you. What can you tell us about Eduardo, the father of Robert, about why is Freddie Roach scared?
Because he knows the Big G don't play games. I mean, the Big G was on since we were kids. He loves the sport, passionate about the sport of boxing, as you can see. He made his two sons world champion and his adopted son, pretty much my brother, a world champion. So, he don't play games, man. He takes fighters and makes them. He doesn't just get them made already. So I think Freddie respects that and knows that. Anybody in boxing should, if you know boxing. And I think that's how you should be when you're a trainer. No games, and that's what Garcia is.
Rios Pacquiao, break it down. November 24th, Macau, China, HBO pay-per-view.
So you're asking me all these fights that I'm going to be biased on. I'm biased because
At least you're honest.
Yeah, no.
But what do you think about the fight?
I think it's a great fight for Brandon. And it's just a great fight for boxing, period. Because Manny's been off and he's got a lot to show. And Brandon is getting underestimated. And I know he doesn't like that. And Brandon's a tough dude. And I'm shooting for Brandon. I want Brandon to take it. I don't know what the breakdown's going to be, but I'm shooting for Brandon to take the fight. I think it's going to be a war. I don't know if Manny's going to be gun-shy still after that knockout. So I'm a shoot for Brandon. My money's on the Oxnard people.
You saw Robert grow up. You saw Robert train. If he had to make a comeback fight, who does Roger Romo want to see Robert Garcia fight? He said Provodnikov, so he can win 4 rounds before he gets knocked out.
Robert was a... I used to see Robert put clinics on in the gym, man, and in the ring. The fights that he lost were really close.
That he was winning most.
Yeah, he was winning, yeah, against, rest in peace, Corrales, Casamayor, Bentaki. Fights like that. I'd like to see somebody that can do well against a boxer, because Robert could box. A lot of people don't remember him, but I do. Me and him used to always tell Fernando, oh, he should turn into a boxer because Fernando was known to brawl back then. And me and Robert were always kicking. He was always hugging me. Yeah, see, Roger boxes. Like, he was just throwing it at Fernando. But I don't know. I'd like to see maybe a dream fight in their prime. Probably a Robert and a Marquez. They're both smart guys.
They can still do it now. Why? They can do it now. Robert comes back, goes out on 147. Marquez.
Robert's doing great as a trainer. He doesn't need
He said he wants one comeback fight.
Yeah?
Yeah?
But
he said Marquez boxes too much.
Well, he didn't box the other night against Bradley, which surprised me. He tried to, but Bradley outboxed him. And when he did put pressure on Bradley, then, it was a different fight. But I don't know. I guess Marquez isn't ready for that.
Okay. Mayweather-Khan, what do you think about that, if that happens? Amir Khan, Floyd Mayweather.
I don't understand why Khan would get a fight like that, but...
Well, he brings two countries. He has speed, he has power, he has...
it doesn't really benefit the fans. Everybody knows what will happen. I got Mayweather taking them out. I mean, I don't think...
But you can say that about anybody.
No, you can, but at least in this last fight, people are saying, oh, well, Canelo's bigger and this and this and that. And, I mean, I had called it. I had told you that, that Floyd was in school, that kid, but... And honestly, no one out there could beat Floyd. I mean, it'd have to be someone like... I mean, back then I was giving a Sergio a chance, Martinez, but Sergio hasn't looked the same, and I don't think he's training the same, so no.
There you have it. Roger Romo here in Oxnard. FaceNewReport.com. I'm Melissa Quack reporting.